Hi, and welcome back to the Blue Screen Brothers. Marius, I think it's time we talk about something related to Terraform on this step-by-step guide series.
Absolutely. So Terraform, well, if you're looking at this, you know what Terraform is, I guess, but it's an infrastructure as code system. So and that is of course usually not running it as an interactive sign-in, right? Where you have a user running stuff like we will be doing it in this video. But anyway, you would rather run it in GitHub Actions or Azure DevOps pipelines and stuff, and then you need to sign in as a service principal. So that's what we're going to show today. A few examples on how to do that.
Perfect.
So should we just go ahead?
Yep.
Let's start in Entra ID and create our app registration. So we click new Terraform 123 and single tenant and no redirect URI. And the reason for that is redirect URI is only needed for interactive sign-ins, and you can easily do multi-tenant app if you want to. And then you could, for example, have a centralized Terraform service principal or app registration, which is consented into multiple of your customers' tenants, for example, or if you're a multi-tenanted organization or similar. So we have now created our app registration, and what we now need to do is this needs some permissions. So let's copy or go to the enterprise application and copy the object ID of it. We can find it in the GUI as well if you want to. We go to subscriptions, we go to IAM on our subscription. We can easily do this more granularly. This was good English. Granularly. if we want to, for example, only delegate a certain resource group. But now we're on the subscription level. So we choose contributor, and here you should limit as much as possible. As you can see, Azure will complain, but let's do this for now. We can either search for the, sometimes it takes a little while to appear. Let's search for Terraform 123 then. Well, now it was there. So we find our service principal and we assign permissions. Okay. We need one more thing, and that is to authenticate. In this recording, we will be doing a client secret for authentication, but you should try to always use federated credentials whenever you can. So we will have a separate episode on federated credentials and use cases for that. But for simplicity's sake here, we will be using client secrets. Okay, so now we have created that. So let's go to our Terraform code. It's not the most complex of code. It's create a single key vault. So we have three ways that we are going to show you this. So first of all, we have our terraform.tf, where I have added Azure RM and Azure AD as providers, and I have the provider block for Azure RM and for Azure AD. So the first option, that is to explicitly define client underscore ID, client secret, and tenant ID, or both of them. And then populate these, for example, with just through a input variable. So this is not the simplest, but it gives some flexibility where I could, for example, have a different variable for Azure AD, meaning that I could have two different service principles for my Azure RM and Azure AD providers, which can be super useful. So now we have these defined. We have our variables already. Very, very simple variable definitions. So let's go to run example one. So what is it that we need first? Well, we have some input that we need. So let's just run, enter tenant ID. Okay. So we find that on directory or tenant ID. Copy and go. We need our client ID, which is this one. Copy and go. And we need the secrets. And we already created it. And this will be visible only until we close our app registration. And we need a subscription ID. So let's find that as well. We have it here. Almost. copy it a bit more. This. Okay, I've already done Terraform init to save some time. And now I can provide these variables. So as you can see, I provide the subscription ID, tenant ID, client secret, and client ID. And these can be provided in, for example, like auto TF vars and other methods as well. But I can run Terraform apply, and we should see this is planning to create our key vault. To save time, we will simply say no. And the fact that it was able to actually do the planning means that it was able to connect properly to our subscription. So that is one way, providing these. And of course, the main thing that you get from this is the ability to split your Azure RM and Azure AD providers into different service principles, essentially. Let's go to example two. So we have the same inputs, but rather than providing these variables on apply as these variables, we can instead populate these environment variables. So what we need to do now first is that we must go to our terraform.tf and just comment out these. Say that we will no longer provide a client ID, secret, and tenant ID directly through variables, but instead we will be sending them as these environment variables. So let's try that instead. Let's just make sure that we are not signed into Azure CLI. Let's go. Let's see if it succeeds now. And it succeeds just as fine. So this is your other option of providing. And this is very common in, for example, Azure DevOps pipelines and GitHub Actions, where you can run everything just by, you have these finished tasks, essentially, that you're running that you need to populate client ID, secret, and tenant ID for, and then it's able to connect. And our third example, we can also, rather than defining the client ID, secret, and tenant ID to Terraform, Terraform also has support for Azure CLI. So we can instead say sign in or AZ login as a service principal, and then try to apply. So now we actually have our environment variables. Let's empty them. Let's just create a brand new terminal just to make sure that everything is sort of from scratch. So now I need my populate my tenant ID and stuff again. Let's go back and find my whatever I called it. Was it this one? We've done that too many recordings. Terraform 1, 2, 3. 3. first we were asked for the tenant ID. And then we're gonna run these. Oops. Then we have client ID. Then we have client secret, and now this will be gone, so we need to create a new one. That is fine. And then we need the subscription ID. So let's actually copy it from a place where it doesn't get a new line in front of it, like this. So now I should be able to log in to Azure CLI. And of course, I can do things like Azure AZ group lists and stuff. And now I can try to apply. Hopefully, this will now plan to create our key vault. And this is where you need to cut it down so that it saves some time for the viewer.
Yeah, but this is three different ways, right? So,
so we do the same exact thing. We do use the same service principle in every three options. It's just three different ways for Terraform to actually be told to use that service principle, essentially.
Yeah, so it's a matter of taste mainly of how we want to perform the task or how you already are used to do it.
A bit of taste, a bit of what is practical, especially when running, for example, in Azure DevOps pipelines. Yeah. Sometimes these built-in job definitions don't necessarily work exactly as you want to. So then it's easier to, for example, start a stage that has AZ login done for you through a service connection, then this will simply work. It can be that you're running it locally or you're running it in some other automation system of some sort where you don't have the option of like service connections and things that you have in DevOps pipelines. For example, in GitHub Actions, you instead have like environment secrets and repo secrets and things, so you can provide these in different manners. So, yeah, it's a bit of taste and it's a bit of what suits your
environment.
Need.
Yeah, perfect. Excellent. But then we have learned something more about Terraform and how to set it up with service principles.
Yes.
Perfect. Okay. Well, thanks for the help, Marius. So
no worries.
Guess we see you next time.
Yes. Bye.
Bye.